Hey guys, Coach Steven here, and today I'm going to be playing with these. So it's winter in here in South Africa, and the weather hasn't been too bad, the overall temperature, but today, jeez, like I don't know if you can see the muscle contraction in my body. This isn't like flexing, this is like everything's like because the wind is bitingly cold. Okay, so like when the wind is still, when there's no wind, the temperature's quite tolerable, but the second the air starts moving, it just drags the heat out of you. It like bites into you. Oh, okay, so gonna play around. With these little weights. So it's nice for you to see my whole body, but get some close-ups as well. So here I'm just doing, this is a very lightweight, this is 1.5 kilograms. But it's just having something in your hand, neurologically, just helps you focus, and also the weight changes gravity. It changes the amount of muscle tension you need to stabilize, which recruits, because it's not so light, it recruits more muscles, it recruits more neurological activity and neurological pathway stimulation. So yeah. Can play around with various movements, and this will just help with focus, coordination development, synergy, flow. I don't know if you can hear, but almost every movement I go through is a click, pop, shift, and it's tissue releasing, joints releasing, joints being lubricated. Yeah, it's muscle tissue changes, myofascial changes, neurological changes, changes on the constriction on the neurovascular bundles. It's getting a bit smoother. I do have quite a severe pain in my lower back at the moment, but from my workouts, I can feel one part of my spine, which was locked up many years ago. I won't give a long story, but for context, I suppose it helps for you to know. I got suplexed, landed on my neck very, very hard, like whoop straight on my neck, and then my whole body folded over backwards that my balls of my feet would kick the floor. Compressed my spine, dislodged my sacroiliac joint, rotated all the vertebrae in my thoracic spine, compressed and flared them out, compressed the vertebrae in my neck, and rotated, they all compressed and locked in on each other. My whole spine was like, fuck, I nearly died. It was very close to paralyzed, but luckily the way it happened, even though there was severe compression and whatnot, my fitness at the time was, I was much stronger and bigger, and I think I just was fortunate that the way I hit and the physical condition of my body stopped myself from completely severing my spinal cord, basically. It took a long time to get recovered from that. I've done tons of physiotherapy and study into physiotherapy and rehabilitation and yoga, Pilates, and all sorts. Because one, I love movement practices, I always have. And two, knowing this stuff helps me be a functional human being. Without it, I would have offed myself, to put it bluntly. My body was so damaged and so, I was in so much constant chronic pain and so dysfunctional for such a long period of time that if I didn't learn and apply how to get better, it would have been the end of me. So yeah, as you can see, my body's restoring to a pretty good level of function from fucked up, because that wasn't even, that was a pretty nasty injury, but I got a list of injuries. That's probably the worst one, but I got a lot of competitors, bam, 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 bam. So, yeah, rehabilitation and different types of functional training, I'm pretty well versed at it. One, out of love and passion, but two, out of necessity. I definitely don't know everything.
So I don't want to come across arrogant. But I know more than your average Joe, and more than your pretty high-level professional in my field. Various fields. I suppose I'm more of a generalist than a specialist. Coaching. field events, dancing. But I'm a very good dancer. I've coached dancers. Yeah, various styles of martial arts, kung fu, boxing, wrestling, BJJ, a bit of Krav Maga, a bit of kung fu, kind of jiu-jitsu and sanshu.
Yeah, studied a little bit into multiple disciplines. Like Bruce Lee, a great deal of respect for Bruce Lee. Now he went and studied, you know, things like fencing, boxing, and he wanted to evolve martial arts. He wanted to evolve his knowledge and his martial arts. He wanted to, know more about how to be better. He studied multiple disciplines, and he helped instill that concept in me when I was young. So, yeah, I would train with everyone and anyone. The more different the style, the better when I was young. Actually, I've always liked that. Because you can go against someone that's a relatively... For example, if you're only a striker, you can roll with someone that's a relative novice to moderately good in wrestling, and they will teach you a world of things. They don't need to be a world champion. They will know so much shit about wrestling that you don't know if they're even moderately good at it and you're not. So yeah, it's always nice to meet people that know more about a specific thing than you. They help. It creates a vacuum to... They're just a spring of knowledge. It creates the vacuum of learning between you and them. It's just a valuable experience if you're open-minded to it. Okay. Playing with hip rotation. This is helping my back. Ooh. Big time. Magnetic linking, joint mobilization through, as well, moving ankle, knee, hip, lower spine, other side, joint positions. If you're paralyzed, you know, this is an extreme scenario, but most of the time, when you can train, you should train a little bit. Because physical exercise and engaging with reality in a physical manner is a very important part of reality. It's a very, very important part of what we are. And if you don't engage in a movement practice, it's going to affect you mentally, emotionally, psychologically, physically, sexually. It will make you a lesser being. Being active makes you more of a human being. It's what we're designed to do. And it is evident in our health and our function. I need to play with core activation because I can feel sometimes my core. I don't get a good synergistic contraction throughout this whole capsule, you know, hamstring tension, quad tension, hip flexors, into the abdominals, the rectus, the obliques, transverse, the quadratus lumborum here in the back, the various spinal erectors, all that stuff, man, and more, all the little pelvic muscles, glutes, extension, getting that all to work synergistically. When you've got it, wow, you feel amazing, you feel on top of your game, you can change direction, you got control in multiple directions and planes and axes and rotation, and like when your core is firing nicely, you feel so good to go, you're so centered. So it's trying to build that connection and coordination in those muscles, as well as creating a mental program, a mental map neurologically in terms of tension and how much tension should be in which muscles to work all together. So you're actually playing with a map, and you're a map of your nerves, and you're growing that map and refining that map and using it better in localized areas. So you're mapping out those nerves in your mind, you're growing them neurologically, your connection to them, and how to use them. That benefits that area, but then you can also integrate that control with control that you have elsewhere. And if you build control locally, and then you learn how to integrate that control globally, you build more and more complex movement patterns. This video has given you some ideas for playing with your body, playing with muscle tension. Look at the breathing and movement in my body, changing tension, playing with control like that. Control range of motion, open, closing off, pulling back, extending through. Flexing forward, stepping through, blowing open, flexing back and rotating. You want to mobilize the spine. I mean, my spine used to be stiff as a board. Look at what it can do now. I couldn't even look left and right. I had to go. Oh, Steve, what are you doing? Sorry, what? For like 9 months. Oh. Hello. Okay, done. Sweet guys. Happy training. Hope you're getting some new ideas, new perspectives. Yeah. Much love. Go well. Cheers.